Hi, I'm Janine, and we are here, Lucy and Yolanda, to show you some bum sculpting moves with these zero leggings and those power leggings. So I hope you're ready. We're gonna go for a 3-minute warm up, then we've got 4 blocks of exercises, each block 4 different exercises, okay? You're gonna spend 1 minute on each, and we hope you enjoy yourself. All right, let's begin, ladies. We're gonna go down into squats. So we're just gonna start mobilizing our legs, our bodies, and just get ready for this great workout that we've got ahead of us. So I just want you to take it down, thinking about your posture, inhaling through your nose, exhaling through your mouth. Toes are lifted, and you are pushing right through those heels. Okay, feeling good, excellent. What I want you to really do is contract those glute muscles when you rise up and just spread out those legs a little bit wider when you go down. That's it. And in 10 seconds, we are going to be stepping forward into lunges. So right foot forward and then bringing it backwards. In 2 and in 1. Let's go for it, ladies. So we're stepping forward here and we're just alternating. Now, exactly. So not going too wide, pushing through that front heel, all energy going through those legs. You should be starting to feel those glutes getting nice and warm and mobile. Excellent. Being aware of your breath constantly. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling out through the mouth. Feeling what it's doing to those glute muscles as you go down. Start squeezing them some more to be aware of what's going on. 5 more seconds, and we're gonna step back into reverse lunges. 2 and 1. So what we're gonna do is just stop in the center and step backwards. That's it. Sticking to one leg though. Getting a little bit deeper. You can even swing those arms. Why not? Enjoy yourself, go with the momentum. 10 more seconds. Big smiles on your faces. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's change legs. Okay, pushing backwards, rising up nice and tall. So the beauty of this is that it's body weight exercises. Don't need any equipment. Get a fantastic burn at the end. 5 more seconds. And we're just gonna go for the hip opener. Our knees are gonna come up to our chest and we're gonna go wide. So we're doing something like this. That's it, we wanna prepare those hips, those legs. We're going to do some more powerful moves. Five more seconds, and it's all about the kickbacks. Our legs are gonna go behind, and our heels are gonna go up to the ceiling. 2 and 1. Right leg, we're gonna go up here, bringing it into the chest, or even up to the hip. Doesn't matter, you can bring it higher. You can even stop in the center if you need to. Just finding that balance. 3, 2, and change legs, see? Doesn't matter, we're all starting somewhere. Excellent, ladies. I want 5 more seconds. I think we're gonna get ready for our workout. It's gonna be 30 seconds on every move. That's unilateral. But if we're working 2 body parts, we're gonna spend 1 whole minute. Okay, feeling warm, ladies? All right, 3, 2, and 1. So we're gonna focus on going into front squats. Nice wide stance, slightly wider than shoulder width. Toes pointed out, arms at shoulder height, okay? We want all the load to go right into the posterior. We're gonna take it down nice and controlled, so at least a count for 2, and you rise up, really squeeze, hold it there for a second. That's it, take it down, and rising up, fantastic. So it's 30 seconds, in fact, no, it's 1 minute, because we're working on 2 body parts, both legs. Keep going, ladies. That's it. After this, we're gonna focus on our right leg and we're gonna be pivoting on our heels. So you're gonna feel the burn in the glute muscle a little bit more. Still coming down, rising up for the last 10 seconds. And 3, 2, and 1. So what you're gonna do here, you're turning onto your side, you're keeping that heel grounded into the floor and you're dropping it down low. And it's 1 and it's 2, exactly. We're gonna keep that consistent, ladies. So 30 seconds on each side. As you go down, really exaggerate those glutes coming out. drawing your navel into your spine, feeling the tension in the leg that's grounded on the floor. Excellent. We want that burn. We want those glutes. I've got 5 more seconds on my clock. We're gonna take it to the other leg. 3, 2, and 1. Let's go for it. Other direction now. Just quickly turning onto your side and bringing it forward. Pivoting. Exactly. Well done. And did I mention that we've got 4 exercises going back to back? And then once we've completed all 4, you'll get a 1-minute recovery. 10 more seconds. Three, two, and 1. We've got a leg abduction. So we're standing tall. We're gonna draw our leg across the body. Now you may feel a little bit wobbly and that's not a problem. If you do, pause in the center and take it back out again. So Lucy can show you that option and Yolanda can stay with me, just swinging. Exactly. 10 more seconds. Getting warmer. 3, 2, and 1. Let's take it to the other side now. So just bringing that leg across your body, controlling through your core, and you should be feeling that nice rounding on the outer part of your glute. Just going past the halfway mark. And right after those, we're gonna go into the great formation of curtsy and side lunge. Stepping out this way and taking it across the body with our leg. In 3, 2, and 1. So with the side lunge, make sure you've got both feet nice and flat. And you can stop in the center if you need to. But we're gonna go straight into the side lunge and the curtsy. So if you wanna take your time just to get yourself used to the move, pause in the center. Otherwise, you go straight into it and you will be feeling those glutes shaping up and feeling that great workout. 5 more seconds here. We're gonna change sides and you're gonna get that recovery you are looking forward to. 3, 2, and 1. Just pausing and stepping out again. Let's go. That's it. Remember, you've got an option. Choose wisely. Last 10 seconds. Three, two, and 1. Go get yourself a drink. You have 1 minute to recover. We'll revisit. We have 4 new exercises. See you there. And welcome back to block 2 of your 4 new exercises. These ones should be a little bit more intense. We're gonna focus on a little bit more pulses and some more contractions, okay? I hope you had a drink of water. We are good to go. Your first exercise will be a split squat. So not a full squat, we're on the back tiptoes here, okay? And we're gonna take it down. You should feel all the energy and the tension going through that front leg here or the leg that's not out to the side. So now that we've established this move, let's lift the leg while we are going down at the same time. So we're here and we are alternating with that move. Okay, and we're gonna spend 30 seconds feeling our legs working. You can pick up the tempo, you don't have to stay with me. So if you feel ready and confident, go with it. So that's you here, driving your elbow and your knee to meet each other. Okay, just 10 more seconds and we're gonna take it to the other leg. Finding that balance and stability and working. You have to have that mind connection though with the glutes. Really focus on getting them working. 3, 2, and 1. Changing sides, offsetting the foot, and we're gonna take it down. So just getting used to the move first, engaging, down again, 1 more, and we're gonna start lifting that leg. Okay, let's go ladies. Lifting, that's it. And if you find more stability again with those arms in front, do what you need to do. It's your body, not mine. I'm just here to guide you and help you enjoy yourself while training. That's it. 15 seconds. We're gonna go into number 2 of 4 exercises. Still breathing, You may be feeling a little bit more hotter. I hope so. That means the body's working. And see, I'm going off balance, but it's absolutely fine. I'm going to guide you with these ladies here, Lucy and Yolanda. Okay, so we're going to go into an extended leg. This one's a bit tricky. So you need that leg out here. You're coming into a nice extended hamstring. Glutes popping out. Rise up, lift. Take it back down, and we're here. Pushing out, rising up, thrusting, and lifting. Okay, let's do this. Right down, pause if you need to, and lift. That's it. Hinging at the hips. Make sure you really contract that glute muscle. That's the only way they're gonna wake up and start building. Well done. I want 10 more seconds from you, and then we're gonna change legs. Remember, positive association. So see the greatness at the end of the tunnel. It's happening. We've got to put that work in. Five more. Three, two, and one. Changing legs, have a breath. Let's go for it. Extend that leg, toes up, heels down, hinging forward. Feel that stretch in those hamstrings. And lift, really forcing those glutes out behind you. And again, well done. That's it. Got about 20 more seconds. Just pacing yourself. But bearing in mind, this is block two. We are no longer beginners, ladies. And we're gonna work. Last 10. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna drop it down to our knees. But we're not gonna stay down. We're gonna have a nice extended body. I'm gonna come up to a squat. Looks like this. Three, two, and one. So carefully coming down onto your knees. And if you find your knees a little bit troubling, you can do what Lucy's doing on my right. And then otherwise, just follow myself and Yolanda. So we're coming up, pushing through our heels, dropping into a squat, taking it back down, finding your balance, rising up again, dropping it into a squat. When you've comfortably found your rhythm, pick it up. That's you. That's it. Nice, deep squat. Fantastic. 30 seconds coming up on one leg, going back down on the same leg, and then change legs. We've got about 10 more seconds. Yes. Well done, ladies, looking amazing. As always, get ready to transition that leg. Four, three, two, and one. Coming up with the opposite leg now. Keep going, Lucy. That's it. Brilliant stuff. Just one last move after this, and we're going for sumo pulses. I'm sure we all know how to do those. But I will show you, if you are not certain, think about that sumo wrestler and that wide stance they make. We're gonna be wide, we're gonna be low, and it pulses for 1 minute. Get ready, get that mind ready. Three, two, and one. Toes out, legs wide, hands to the ground. Let's do this. Pulses. Come on, push. That's it. We will recover after this. You have 1 minute to recover after this. Focus, focus, focus. That's it, keep that head up. Feeling the burn, pushing through the burn. Nothing else matters right now, so you zone out and switch off. Yes, we can. That's what we tell ourselves when we know this. 10 more seconds to go. Gritting the teeth if you need to. Five, four, three, two, and celebrate you. Go and get a drink, get a towel, and I'll see you in block three. Welcome back. We're now into block three, where we're going to spend four exercises working on the floor. So what we need you to do is just start setting yourself out on your back. We're going to go into a glute bridge, which consists of you flattening your shoulder blades like so, bringing your right leg over your left knee, and raising your hips up nice and high. I want you to really focus on keeping the heels dug through the ground though, and toes pointed to the ceiling. Immediately you feel some tension in your abdominals, absolutely fine, but I want you to focus on this glute and hamstring. And we're gonna take it down to the ground, nice and controlled, thrusting up nice and high. So we're gonna go down again and thrusting, really focusing on that squeeze at the top. We're spending 30 seconds here, and then we'll change legs and enjoy ourselves. So back to back, four exercises, and you're halfway there. So keep going up and rising. Trying to avoid, though, touching the ground. We want to get that nice hamstring glute tie definition. Just 5 more seconds and then we're going to swap over. And change. Quick change here. Raising that leg, raising the hips, and go for it. Now you may feel a little bit tighter on the other side. Not a problem. Everyone experiences it. We're just going to correct those imbalances. So still working. We're about halfway there. Reaching up and taking it down nice and controlled. And after this, we'll dig both feet, heels on the ground, and we're gonna go for a little heel walk forwards and backwards. In 5 seconds, we're gonna take it down. In 3, 2, and 1. So placing both heels on the ground, focusing, keeping the toes up, and I want you to really go for 5 controlled steps outwards, feeling the tension in those hamstrings. When you're there, bring it backwards, and we're here. So we're gonna go for at least 5 steps. So let's take it out, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and bringing it back, feeling the tension. It's only 30 seconds that's required here, because we're gonna start going with an abduction of both legs, going outwards, externally rotating at the hips. Last 5 seconds, and focus on keeping the hips up. 2, and 1, so now raise up as high as you can. Heels are still dug down, and we're opening and pulsing. Feeling the little burn, or the big burn, in our glutes. Still drawing our navel into spine, and just flapping those wings. We've got 10 seconds here, then we're gonna roll over. And you're gonna give me some donkey lifts, straight leg lifts. Okay, feeling the burn. Just 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, and carefully come up, and let's roll over onto our front. So, just here, making sure you get your wrists underneath your shoulders. You can also come onto your elbows if you find that more comfortable for you, okay? But let me just demonstrate what I really need you to do. So we're here, straight leg comes out to the side, and we're lifting and placing it over the leg on the opposite side. Lifting nice and high, and taking it over. Try not to dip too low in the tummy, and think about the shaping that we're making with those buns right behind us. Okay, pointing down and heel to the ceiling. Just 10 more seconds. Like I say, the beauty of this workout, you can pick it up at your own tempo as long as you are maximizing your 30 seconds. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Or you might even need to sit back down, release the tension, and change side. Okay, let's go for it. Lifting. That's it. Enjoy. Keeping those heels up nice and high. Scooping up around you, making that semicircle. Pinching in the waist every time. And we've got 10 more seconds to our last one in this block. Three, two, and one. Okay, so extending your legs now. You can rest your head down onto your arms. Okay, well, these are called superwoman legs. So I want you to lift and focus on the lift in the glute at the upper part. When you're ready, you can pick up the tempo like so. Otherwise, follow my girl Lucy. She'll be dropping the tempo down, and we will be working this for 1 minute. Let's go. That's it. Feeling the lift, feeling the tension. Spending 30 seconds with these pulses, and then we're gonna take it to an iso hold, that final burn. 10 seconds. Doing brilliantly, ladies. Keep going, keep breathing. 5 more. 3, 2, 1. Now hold it up there and don't give up. It's number 4, and you will get the recovery straight afterwards. So stick with us and enjoy it most of all. Keep going, 20 seconds to go. Feeling that tension, everything's coming together. You're doing amazingly well, so keep it up. 15 seconds left. Pushing, gritting your teeth, seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. 10 seconds. If you feel that they're sinking, keep pushing, keep thinking about that purpose. 4, 3, 2, and release. Wow, 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 wow. Okay, well done. You might want to sit back on those heels and let the blood flow. 1 minute recovery, and we'll see you in block 4, the final block. Welcome back. Block 4, this round of 4 exercises consists of more cardio-based movements. We want to finish strong, we want to finish powerful, and we want those glutes to burn and get the rewards that we signed up for. So, first exercise will be 2 squats down, we're going to jump forward, and we're going to jump backwards. Okay, pretty straightforward, so let's go for it. 1 minute here, and here we go. 1, 2, jump forward, jump backwards. Excellent, keep it going. Hey, doesn't matter, we go for it. We just keep moving. Yes, team, and I'm gonna follow you. You keep going. I want 2 squats. I wanna jump forward, I wanna jump backwards. And if you feel that you need to take the tempo down, you take the tempo down and you give me a step forward and a step backwards. That's it, ladies, keep going. I have about 8 more seconds left of this move. Then we're gonna hold a curtsy, looking like this in 3, 2, 1. Hold it there. And don't give up. That's it. Curtsy. Just curtsying. Just enjoying yourself. A little bit deeper. See you coming up. Feeling the tension right here. 15 seconds. That's it. Breathe. Get your thoughts together. 2 more exercises to come. And in 7 seconds, we're going to change legs. 4, 3, 2, 1. Change it over. Let's go. Curtsy style. Fantastic. Your number 3 move will be a sprawl. Hands are gonna be on the ground, you're gonna be jumping forward, and legs are going backwards into a squat. 15 seconds, get a little bit deeper. That burn is real, team. 10 more, come on. Yes, we can. Yes, we will. I hear you breathing, ladies. It's working. 4, 3, 2, hands down on the ground, plank position. We're gonna go for 2 squat pulses. Let's leap forward. 2 and back. That's it. You can have a pause and just keep bouncing, pushing backwards and jumping forward for 2, ladies. That's it. Make me proud. Good. Nice flat feet. Heels down. Big smiles on your faces. You are having an amazing time. I know. Keep going. Wonderful. We have 15 seconds on the clock. Then it's stomper time. Our final one in this block. And we're going to speed up those legs. They're going to be driving forward. They're going to be driving backwards. My ladies are heavy breathing right now. They're working hard. 4, 3, 2. Let's go with our right leg. We're coming down into a lunge stance. And we're driving like a sprinter about to take off on the track. Here, pushing back, forward, here. Yes. Just 30 seconds on each leg. If you're not sure on the form, I'm going to show you this way. Just down, here, push, here. That's it. Getting those glutes out. Feeling that burn. Looking straight ahead, there's light at the end of the tunnel. Come on, we got 10 whole seconds. Yes you can, and you will. Come on, 5, 4, 3, 2, change legs, balance it off, we've got 2 legs. Let's work it. Celebration comes after this. And again, that's it. Make sure those feet are nice and flat, by the way. Make sure those heels are down and those glutes are down. Don't creep up, I see you. Yes you, I see you. Come on, 12 seconds, and again. Pushing, breathing, believing. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, and well done. Okay, you've got a 1 minute recovery because we have 2 minutes worth of finishes, 1 minute each, then we're done. Have a drink, see you then. So now it's time for your finishes. We have 2 minutes worth of work. You're gonna spend 1 minute doing a squat with some feet kick outs, then you're gonna go into a reverse lunge and a knee drive. I'm gonna just demo now, so we're just here, kicking out, okay? 1 minute is spent here. If you need to modify, just keep your eyes on Lucy. She's gonna give you those pulses, okay? We're all good to go. 3, 2, and 1, let's go for it. That's it, just have a great time bouncing. 1 whole minute, not long. It's not 1 hour, ladies and gents. It's just 1 minute. That's it. Pushing, pushing. Inhale, exhale, bouncing. Fantastic. Guess what? We're nearly halfway there. Whoa, I know I feel it. I don't know about you, Leander. I feel it. I've got about 20 seconds. Even if you want to modify, you can still be here. Look, there are options for everyone. Last 10, you're doing brilliantly, Leander. And you, Lucy. Come on, push through. 5, 4, 3, 2, recover. Quick. 5 to 10. Second recovery, your next one. Reverse, high knee. Reverse, high knee. 3, 2, 1, let's go. That's it. Little quicker. Push. Drive it. Yay. Feel that burn. Come on, even swinging those arms. Love what you're doing. Only 30 seconds. Hear that breath. I'm working too. Come on, come on. Push. Final exertion of energy. 5, 4, 3, 2. Change leg. Quick change. Let's go. Up. Yes. Work it. Make sure those legs stay down. And again, big inhale, big exhale. Work it. Final hurdle. Getting through. Last 12 seconds. Working those arms. Working those legs. 8 more. Yes, you can. 5, 4, 3, 2. And shake it out. And well done. Time to cool down. Get your mat or not. We're not going to bother. We're going to take it down to the floor. So all we've got to do, push your leg back into a lunge, resting down. Okay, turning your foot out. You can slightly open up the hip flexor here, or if you can, bring the elbow to the ground. Love this one. If that's too low, just keep your hands in contact with the floor. And just go for a few deep breaths here. Let the muscles lengthen, let the heart rate come down, and just zone out completely. Okay, taking time to rise up. And let's fully extend that leg in front of us, heel down, toes up to the ceiling. If you can, lowering the head as close to the knee as possible. Feeling that nice release in your hamstrings at the back. Very good. I want to spend at least 15 to 20 seconds here. Excellent. Let's take the same leg and tuck it underneath into our pigeon stretch. Nice release of tension in the glutes we've been building up. Resting down, either on your arms, if you can, taking your head to the ground. Excellent. Love this one. Okay, we're going to repeat everything on the other leg. So let's carefully bring in our right leg back to center, and we're coming up into our lunge. So just widening those hips a little bit more, and then taking our elbow or hand onto the ground. And now let's extend that leg, toes up, ceiling, heels through the floor, and head down low. And now time to finish off with our pigeon. Wrapping that leg underneath you, as wide as you can, and resting down. Excellent. Now we're going to release this leg, and we're just going to sit on our heels. You can go a little bit wider, making sure the torso has a nice, comfortable positioning in between the legs, but if that's too far for you, just keep them close and just sit back as far as you, your body will allow you. Brilliant work. Okay, from the plank position, we're just going to bring our hands, our wrists underneath our shoulders, legs extended behind us. I want you to really focus on getting your heels to touch the ground. So if you need to bring your feet closer to your hands, walk them forward. And we're in almost downward dog position, feeling that lengthening in the back of your legs. And what I want you to do is bring your hands slowly towards your toes. So walking backwards, nice straight legs, glutes in the air, and just hang here for a moment, feeling that nice release in the back of your legs. Just softly uncurl. And we're just gonna go and bring our knee to our chest, find balance and stability, pushing all energy through the foot that's grounded on the floor. May feel wobbly, but it's okay. You can hold it to something if you need to. Let's take the same leg backwards and thrust our hips forwards. So we're here. And let's change leg. So knee up to the chest. Head nice and tall. We're confident, we're happy. We completed our workout. 30 minutes, bringing those legs back. And we can finish off with the rest of our day. We hope you had a great time. Let's go into a nice wide stance. Big inhale as we go into our nice wide squat. Try and get as deep as you can, ladies. All the way down again. That's it. Change the direction of your arms. We're gonna go for two more squats. Big inhale, big exhale. Last one. And we did it. High fives, ladies. Yes, yes. I'm Janine, Lucy, Yolanda. Thank you so much for joining us for this bum sculpting workout. Don't forget to head over to the Sweaty Betty YouTube channel where you can subscribe for more workouts just like this. So get involved. Ciao.